Hey everyone, I hope you're well. Today I am going to explain another interesting and popular code of C programming, which is the digital clock code. To program a digital clock code with local time, first we need to store the time in form of seconds. And then we should get the current time of our PC using the function local time. What this does is it will get our current time from the PC and store it in the variable we have allotted for it. After getting the time from the PC, we need to use the dynamic memory allocation and get the time in form of hours, minutes and seconds during compilation time and store it in their respective variables. Now, after doing this, the main part of the code comes where we should calculate the seconds and then increment the minutes, increment the hours, and then print it. Now, we all know that a while loop with no terminating condition leads to infinite loop. Now, to print the digital clock, we are making advantage of that infinite loop so that we can constantly keep printing the time. And also, we need to keep in mind that we need to erase the output window after each and every single second so that it would be clean and neat and organized. Now, to clean the window, we are using systemcls, which this does is just it simply erases the output window after every output. And then we need to print the time in form of hours, minutes and seconds. After that, we are using flush std out. What this does is nothing but reduces the buffer time of the output window so that we can constantly get the output. And now we are calculating the seconds. Here we are incrementing seconds. So we are give. So I gave second plus plus, and then if we are checking here conditions. Why? Because if the seconds goes more than 60, we need to increment a minute. So we done the same condition here. If second equal to 60, minute increments, and then second again resets to zero. Now the same happens with the minutes too. If minutes exceeds more than 60, then we need to reset it and increment a hour. This is what we done here. And after 24 hours, we need to reset everything. So I used this condition. If hour is equals to 24, then it would get resetted. Now here we are using sleep 1. What this does means it will give a 1 second delay so that we can calculate the approximate time by 1 second. To use this sleep function, we need to declare a header file called hashtag include time.h. Now let's see how this works. Let's view compile and run. It might take a while. Now here you can see that the time has been inputted from my PC. You can see that my PC's time is 1716, and the time in my program is also 1716. Now here every second is incremented. Wait, something I made a mess. Yeah, you can see that every second is incrementing. You might be wondering, how did I change the background and the text color of the output window? It's simple. It's very simple. We should use system color function. What this does is it will change the color of the output window. Here are the colors you can choose. If you give something out of that range, it will show you the dialog box where you can where the codes for colors is given. Here it represents 0 equal to black, 1 equal to blue, 2 equal to green, 3 equal to aqua, 4 equal to red, 5 equal to purple, 6 equal to yellow, 7 equal to white, and vice and etc etc. For example, I need aqua blue for background, so the aqua blue code is 3. I am giving 3, followed by the text color. I need bright white so that it looks nice. Now if I execute, you can see that it printed in white and the background is aqua blue. Let me illustrate another example for these colors. If I want green on white, green code is 2 and bright white code is F. So what this does is it will print green background and bright white text on it. Let us check. See, the link of this code is given in the description down below. That's it for today. If you do like this video, smash that like button. For more videos, subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.